Look at it. His barracks is the only thing he has to spot for him right now. As you can see, he doesn't have comm set centers, which you kind of need to get that extra sight advantage, sight range for your tanks. And now fOrGG's gonna switch back up and go back to the other ramp and go up the back side again, and just forcing FireBatHero to switch back and forth and back and forth, switch his focus, forcing him to try and defend two positions at once, and he just can't. He just does not have the resources to defend two positions. He doesn't even have the resources to defend one position at once, let alone two. FireBatHero has a little bit of a siege advantage here, being able to fire up from the low ground before fOrGG's tanks are in place, but no, he's just got too many tanks, and he's going to siege up behind where he can actually attack the SCV line. Oh, man, taking out a tank as well. This is just horrible, horrible for FireBatHero. I think this is pretty much game, actually. I mean, the game is still going on. It's impossible for FireBatHero, theoretically, to fight his way back into it, but FireBatHero has just taken too many losses and has too much of a disadvantage here. I don't think he's going to be able to come back in this game. He's just losing a lot of forces. It looks like that Wraith is going to come out at just the right moment, and it's going to be able to chase off those last couple tanks from doing any more damage to his economy, but he's going to be able to get an armory up. It looks like he's going to get an armory up to deal with the Wraiths, but I think that was fOrGG's armory. But fOrGG expanding again now, and that's exactly... I think he should have even expanded earlier. Oh, what are you doing? Get that last hit on it. There you go. Kills off that tank. I'm not sure why he's not going in for more hits with this Wraith right now. But anyway, FireBatHero actually has a decent amount of tanks he's built up now, and managed to pick off one or two tanks with the Wraith and with the last bit of his defense. So he may have evened things back up in terms of tank counts. But he's found that expansion that fOrGG is trying to put up. So we may actually be seeing a longer game here with both players kind of setting up their firing lines with huge lines. We see this on Medusa a lot. Well, not a lot, but often in TVT. Most of the time in TVT, actually. Oh, and he kills off the SCV making the expansion, so that's going to slow that down as well. FireBatHero needs his own expansion, though. He needs to take the 9 o'clock, though, here. Pretty quick, or he's just going to be in bad, bad shape. There's the Goliaths out now for fOrGG, so he's going to be able to deal with the Wraiths. Having to remake his barracks so he can make more factories. But yeah, FireBatHero needs to take his own expansion here, otherwise he is going to get out macroed once fOrGG gets that expansion up in the top right again. Looks like FireBatHero might be moving in for a bit of an attack. He's going to use that Wraith to spot. Oh, what's he going to do? Oh, he's going to siege within range. I don't know if fOrGG has the sight range. Yes! FireBatHero gets the first siege volley off, which immediately made those tanks visible, but he got the first volley off, so he was able to actually kill more tanks with his own and keep the numbers even, though fOrGG, I think, had a couple more tanks. FireBatHero getting that first volley off was able to do more damage and kind of even things up there. FireBatHero now having to produce Goliaths as well, just in case fOrGG, which he should anticipate he's going to do, makes dropships or Wraiths of his own or something like that. Wow, taking out another tank there. Nicely done. Nicely done. Losing a tank of his own, though. His defense is starting to get a little skimpy in the middle there. And fOrGG, again, critically, is just getting that third base up in the top right. He's going to be able to start out-producing FireBatHero very, very quickly. He's got his barracks up now. He's going to make more factories. And he's going to be able to basically... He's going to have that third gas. And you kind of... It's kind of one and a half machine shop. Well, kind of one machine shop per gas. If you're only producing tanks and you're not upgrading or teching or anything like that, it's one and a half machine shops per gas. Although I guess if he's making Goliaths too, then it's basically like one. But yeah, so those three gases basically means he's going to be able to produce one and a half times the amount of units that FireBatHero is with only the two gas. He's already behind. Look at this. Look at the superior force that fOrGG has in the middle. Going and moving and sieging up. No vision for FireBatHero. And fOrGG this time is going to get the first tank volley off. Completely popping a tank before it's even able to get a hit off. FireBatHero needs to repair that. There he goes. And fOrGG getting up a fourth base. FireBatHero, if he does not do something right now, he needs to go take out some bases right now. Or pull off something spectacular right now. Or he is just dead in the water. He's just barely getting his third base up at the 9 o'clock position, but he is just going to be so far behind, though, because his third base is even up behind, and it looks like that may even get attacked, and now fOrGG moving around from the north is going to come in and attack FireBatHero's weak point, the top of his line instead of the side of his line and destroy, just pop that tank there. FireBatHero is going to try and move in here to protect this 9 o'clock expansion, which again is again pretty critical. Oh, he does not manage to kill off the SCV before it produces, finishes that command center. That would have been really, really good. It would have been able to delay that command center and take even more of an economic lead. But look at this. fOrGG's tank line is now, instead of becoming a line, that's becoming a curve, it's becoming a crescent, a noose, kind of slowly tightening around FireBatHero's neck, just coming in from the right and from the north, from the top, and now he's got him basically contained both ways. So there's no edge of the line that FireBatHero can use to attack. The only way to, if the enemy has superior tank forces, the only way to overcome is to come from the side, like we saw fOrGG do from the north. But here he is, constricting the knot a little bit tighter, coming in a little bit closer, and FireBatHero has no weak point to attack here. He can't even use the raise. fOrGG is doing a good job of holding his Goliaths back, and using them, just a couple of them, to support his tanks and keep his tanks safe from the raids. And for some reason, I just had a flashback to watching Stargate Atlantis, because the bad guys in that show are the Wraith. But, oh my god, he needs to protect him from the Wraith. Anyway, sorry. Some Wraiths now coming in for fOrGG. Completely takes out FireBatHero's Wraith in a moment. Just taking it out very quickly. FireBatHero not having the time to respond. And FireBatHero has lost his Goliath. He had some earlier just in case of this kind of an attack. But he's lost them now, and those raids are going to work. They've taken out two tanks. They're taking out a third tank right now. Some SCVs coming off the line to try and desperately repair those tanks. But now, fOrGG has enough of an advantage. He's just going to march straight in here and just totally attack this expansion on the left here. Some SCVs coming out, but they're going to get popped before they even reach those tanks. Not even getting out close enough to absorb some hits and redirect some splash damage onto the friendly tanks, onto fOrGG's friendly tanks. So this is pretty much over, folks, because look at this. fOrGG has just a ton of tanks, and FireBatHero has very, very few. I'm sure if we were able to see the supply count right now, FireBatHero probably has, maybe 60 or 70 supply, and fOrGG, I'm sure, has 120 or something like that. Huge, huge advantage here. And FireBatHero has a bunch of dropships for no reason that aren't doing anything. So nicely done, FireBatHero, getting those dropships out, but, not going to do any good. I guess you're going to be able to ferry your SCVs out of danger. Nicely done. But they're not going to do you any good without any forces in them. And even if you did have forces to put in them, that squad of Wraiths is going to be able to easily take care of any dropships that try and drop on top of his tank. So fOrGG getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bases up. For FireBatHero brought back down to 2. I'm not sure why FireBatHero is still in this game. Maybe it's because it is the ace match. So I don't know. So KT is going to go up, and they're going to they just beat the Estro team, who did very well, beating a few teams in a row, beating NBC and We Made, I believe, and I think maybe it was just those two teams. But now KT finishing off Estro, and is now going to polish off Khan in a 7-game set, not even having to bust out any of their quote-unquote big guns, although fOrGG, I guess, could be considered one of their big guns. They paid a lot of money for him.
So, they are going to go on to face the next team, which, let me double check here in the background. They're going to be facing CJ next, and actually, since I'm having to resync this game a few days after I actually recorded this commentary, I've already seen the games versus CJ, so I won't be casting those. The winner of that match will then go on to face Sparkies, Height Sparkies, and then the winner of that match will go on to face Hwasong Oz, and then the winner of that match will go on to face SKT1, and then the winner of that match will go on to face STX Seoul, since it is the Gyeongnam STX Masters Cup. It's their cup, so they get to pretend that they're really cool and pretend that they're the first place team and be the top team. Although STX did do very well this last season, they are one of my favorite teams, and I don't mean to belittle them at all. But, so it's basically just kind of going up the rankings, and, so Easter did pretty well, getting a few teams up in the rankings before, going down to KT. We'll see how far KT can go. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this whole set. Not the highest Q caliber of games, but still pretty good, entertaining games nonetheless, I think. And I hope you guys enjoyed the whole set. And again, I apologize about the mic problems in Game 5 there. But yes, I'm going to try and fit in a couple more games here before BlizzCon, which is this weekend. But if not, then I will hopefully do some next week. Yeah, and if you're going to BlizzCon, track me down. I'll be that guy with the hair. And yeah, say hi. All right, take care. Thanks very much for watching, and... Mahalo.